up, everybody? This is day 212, Make It Songbringer. And, man, I'm really excited because this file tree I've improved a lot. Did some improvements, pushed it up to GitHub. That's cool. And today I'm going to be working on this harpy type, sort of a harp, slash a harpy slash, oh, sorry, it might have been loud. This chick right here, basically. I'm drawing this, so this will be like a level entrance, I'm thinking. At first I had planned to just make it a pillar type thing, right? She would be standing there on a pillar, it would just be a static entity. What's up, Momir? And so, yeah, but I think this is actually going to be cool enough to be a level entrance, so this will be like level entrance 2 or something. So I'm going to dive right into the code, getting this all hooked up in there and putting it at the right point. And then I'll start working on some art, making her look better, and add some other stuff. There's going to be some pillars over here surrounding. There's going to be a forest in the background, sort of like a circular type Stonehenge looking type thing. And then in the middle, she'll be sitting on top of something where maybe you can walk down inside into a cave where there's another elevator going down to a level. That's the plan. So yeah, let's get this code rocking. I've already got it set up so she's an entity or a tile type that I can put in. But I'm not gonna need that anymore because I think she's gonna be a level entrance. So this was called the Hark. Actually, we can just leave that. It's because there's a K-tile entrance. And this gets set in pattern entrance. Let's do this way. What's up, Arcor? Yeah, it's going good, man. What's up, Blood? Yeah, I'm gonna be working on this art scene right here. This is gonna be like a level entrance with this chick standing on top of a, like a statue or metallic statue, something like that, standing on top of something inside sort of like a Stonehenge-y area. So yeah, I'm just setting up the entities for that to work. So if this flags and K flag, so this is the second entrance, then we're gonna do this pattern hark. I'm calling her the hark. She's halfway between a harpy and a hawk. Yeah, hopefully she gets a little sexier with some shading. I'm sure this will look a lot more. All right, so we don't need the pattern hark anymore. To be called from here, we don't need that. All right, cool, I think we're ready to do this. Let's take a look at the world and find out where level entrance 2 is so we can do this. It's right here at 9, 8, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 9, 4. Okay, cool. 9, 4 it is. Let's put the player there. Yeah. What's up, Alex Pita? I'm working on this this new level entrance. It's gonna be mostly an art day. I've already been coding all this morning. I got like 2 bugs fixed. It was awesome. Actually, really important bugs though. There's this bug where the save data grew and grew and grew and grew, and all of a sudden my save data was like 41 megs. Okay, cool. So we've got an area. It's running the right area. What do we have here? Okay, so that's. We need to put in, of course, the right edges for this to connect and everything. Now we're gonna need some forest around here in a circle. Okay, so that's how this scene works here, like that. Yeah, I mean it's not even done yet, but yeah, it'll look a lot better once I do the art. Oh, really? Nice. Is it your birthday? Or is it almost your birthday? Whoa, and into us, right on. Haha. Dude, what a great gift. That's awesome, man. I like your pillow over here. Yes. Oh, that's so rad, dude. This is a really good one. Hell yeah. Now, what you got to do is let it sit on your shelf for about a year and just collect a lot of dust. That's the best way to learn. Telling you. No, I'm joking. I'm definitely joking. That's what I did, though. Yeah, that thing. Is that who was his name from South Park? Or is that just a. Oh, it's on Wednesday? Nice, cool. Happy birthday, man. Mr. Hanky, that right? Oh, the WhatsApp emoji. Really? Oh, yeah. I've seen my girlfriend use that emoji before too. All right, now we got some edges, but I want them to be circular, not square like that. I think one of these is a circle. Maybe two. I really should put some defines for that. Some constants for area styles. Yeah, I think that's circular. But I want to widen it out. Yeah, Alex Pita and Marza have a long friendship, so they give each other the business every time. All right, we need more space. It's next Wednesday. Oh, right on, man. We'll have be an early birthday. So, to widen this out, make this quadrant a little wider. Twenty-nine. Oh, right on. You're so young, man. You're 29 too? Concave sine wave. So if I put a minus two there, let's see what that does. Good for you, man. You got so much ahead of you. Yeah, 29's young. I'm not sure if this is working. Nope. Okay, that must be the other one. Either that or this isn't. Oh, whoops, sorry. There we go. Okay, so I must have mixed up my convex and concave. Which one's which? Right? 50 plus is old. So old. Oh my god. No, I'm pretty. It's weird, but I feel older every day. I'm 35 now. Which one's which? Concave is like cave, right? Yeah. Okay, so I totally messed these up, these namings, but just in here. Will be an X-rated game? No. So this one is concave. This one's convex. It's sort of a goddess. I'm not exactly sure. There's probably need to be some lore around this girl, the Hark or whatever. You made an intro right on Mars of Power. What's up? Alex Pita. Yes, Pierre's culinary adventure. Oh, dude. I love it, man. I love it. Oh, you got like yellow bell peppers now and garlic and salt. Yeah, that's right? What's up, Caviar? I'm working on this girl being a level entrance. So that's today's no one really knows. That's right. Let's give that a minus two. This one we'll leave alone. So the concave sine wave. Yeah, it can be like really, really wide. Okay, a little more, because this is going to be zero, so let's make that minus three. You've heard a tremor in the force? All right, maybe one more, actually. No, I don't know. This is kind of good right there. Yeah, let's try one more though, just to step over the line and then step back. Oh, is that why you connected? You're a time traveler and you're a Jedi? Wow. Yeah, that was like one too much. That was definitely one too much. So this would be minus three, and then we can control the thickness of this whole shape. Yeah, and it's just about time I should have a shape style for this. First let's put in some rocks for pillars. Jonah19, what's up, man? And And you're a bread baker, right? That's definitely a superpower. This is going to be a level entrance, and somebody should write some lore for her. I don't know what she is. She's like halfway from a hawk to a harpy. So I'm gonna be shading her and drawing her and making her look cool. But first, I'm putting in these pillars around her to make like a sort of Stonehenge-like area. Yeah. All right, now we can do the pattern arc. Let's throw in a Stonehenge like stuff. The God of Bread. Get a number of rocks, eight, maybe seven. So float angle equals something. Yeah, he is. Time traveler, Jedi, bread maker, photographer, programmer. Yes. Yeah, angle is gonna be float I over float N. N. And then this is times m pi over 2. We'll get that in the next part of this algorithm. Sometimes programmer. Probably not. Yeah, I'm probably not gonna animate her. Because I would animate her, right, and bring her to life and stuff, but I really don't have that much more time in this game. I have 4 months. That seems like a while, but it's not at all. It's gonna go by fast, and I have a lot of bosses to create, enemies to create, and other things I need to bring to life. So I can't really animate this, but it'll, I'll at least make it look dope. Yes. You don't understand the why of pointers? Dude, the why of pointers. Let me show you a couple whys of pointers. First of all, it's not always expedient to use a reference. Do you understand references, though? Re that might be a bad thing to start with. Here's sort of a cool thing, sort of C-like thing, right? If int p, let's do an array of 10 ints. You could go like this: int pointer q equals p. Watch this: q plus plus. Bam! Now I'm pointing at the second element. That's pretty dope. This is pointer math. You got to understand this stuff. Yeah, you'll get That's just supposed to be a shadow. No, yeah, she's just gonna be a metal thing. Yeah, so I'm gonna work on these shadows. Like I really haven't done much at all to her look, so I need to shade, make this all. You're right, it is too much shadow, so it gives her a bush. So I don't know. We'll have to tone down on that shadow. There really is a lot of reasons to use them. So but references make them less useful, but still there are still reasons why you would have to use a pointer versus a reference in certain cases. But yeah, keep learning it, you know, keep soaking it up before you go to bed, especially read that kind of information, and you'll eventually it'll totally make sense. No, you're not forced to use pointers in C++ or C. No, pointers are not faster in C or C++. They're the same exact speed. Yeah, caviar, exactly the same. Yeah. That does not matter at all. So you can go int pointer foo. Same exact thing as this. But I prefer this one because that kind of implies that the pointer aspect is a part of int rather than an aspect of the variable name. And it also kind of is confusing to me because like you might be multiplying that variable name at some point. So I just think it's clearer to put it over here, but it really doesn't matter to the compiler. Yeah, that's the same exact thing too. It doesn't matter. You could put a million spaces in between on either side of these, and it would still make an int pointer. So let's go like this: float percent float angle equals m pi. We want to go 2 pi over float in. Times percent. All right, now the position is going to be cosine and sine off that. No, definitely not silly questions. Yeah. That's a good point for doing it that way, Momir. Yeah. Oh. We'll do it like this. In x equals cos ep angle times width. Think this is supposed to be cos and sine. Sine angle times x, y, tile type k, tile. Statue. And of course there needs to be a margin too, so this is going to be cos f angle times width minus margin times 2 plus margin. This one, height minus margin times 2 plus margin. All right, let's see if this works. What's up, professional novice? So true. All right, we got a couple of statues there on the right, but they're all at one little angle. That's so weird. Percent should be I over N. That should be right. Memory is the key. Yeah, professional novice. Oh, high five to this right here. That's awesome. Yeah. Hey, this is why you have your name. Oh, I get it now. Wait a minute, I don't think that's right. It's supposed to be over N. Huh. Yes. All right, best thing is just to step through this, see all these variables. First one, percent. Zero. I is 0 of 8. The angle for that, 0, of course. Margin X comes out to be 17. Okay, so that's putting it on the Y comes out to be 4. So that's straight down. Okay, wait, set the breakpoint here. We got I1, percent 0.2, 0.1, angle 0.78, margin X is this time 13, so it's gone to the left a little. Y is 12, that's so wrong. What? Yeah, you totally can, if you want to. If this is something that your heart says, yes, I want to learn that, then you will. Okay, this time we've got X equals 4, Y equals 16. That's so wrong. It's totally wrong. That's the bottom left. Why isn't this right? Sine and cos should be there. What? Oh, duh. Because it's not from the center. Okay, so that's sine f angle plus, not plus margin, but plus width over 2. Let's do this. Constant W2 equals width. Oops. H2 height. W2, H2. Okay, and then here we'll do width. What's up, Mike? Yeah. Yeah, true. You don't need all of it. Yeah, definitely start learning the 2011 one or 2014. They're basically about the same. Unreal. What's up, man? So that gives it a radius of W2 minus margin for the X, H2 minus margin, and then that adds to H2 to give you an offset. Yeah, I think that should work this time. What's up, Azimris? Hello, defense. Defense. Oh, I get it. I get it now. Cool. You're nice, right on. Yeah, I'm working on this this ring of Stonehenge-like circles that are gonna go around this like half hawk, half harpy thing, and then inside here there's gonna be a level entrance. Oh, sorry, you guys are talking about something else. I thought you were talking about C++. Versions. All right, X10. That's halfway. Y16. That works. Cool. Next one. X14, Y14, X16, Y10. Yeah, here we go. This is working now. Bam! All right, here we've got it. We're finally drawing a circle accurately. You think I have some kind of like algorithm already in place for that? There we go. Okay, we've got a circle, Stonehenge-like rocks inside this thing. Well, now we need to move them down a little bit. Maybe four. Hey, what's up, Gladiar? Hello, Kotai Bodge. All right, that's a little weird. I'm not sure why this statue is like that down there. Yeah, so four was a bit too much. Let's try three. Yeah, it's growing, right? The game's growing, the following's growing. The game's getting ready for alpha release soon. Advanced alpha release. All right, I'm just gonna have to move her a little higher because this is getting weird. So we need, let's try H type minus two that time. Swords and batteries. Still weird how we're getting that one statue right there. Thanks, Kotai. Yep, shaders are definitely they add a lot to the whole look of the game. Still, we've got a weird. Oh man, that's so crazy. What if I do nothing? Apple TV port, I don't know. I just heard about that this week from Marzipower. And I guess if there's If it's easy to do, why not? Okay, let's do 7 instead of 8. -2. Make the Harpy go ka-ka! Yeah, it does look like a Valkyrie, right? With her helmet. Sword cooldown? Like, what do you mean? Huh? What would a sword cooldown be like? What's that, All right, yeah, so it needs minus if the sine is less. So let's do this. Flow sine equals sine f sine, and sine is less than 0. Zero, otherwise 1. What you mean? There, now they're kind of evenly spaced. Except for the top one. Basically, in the next version of Minecraft, you cannot spam the sword attack. We have to wait a little between the two secret ones. Oh, it's already kind of built in. So check this out. If you have what a. What sword does he have here? Fire. Yeah, whoops. So you can't use your sword until the fireball or whatever, if you have one of these ghost swords, right? Watch me, I'm trying to, every time I swing while there's another sword already in the air, it doesn't launch another one. So no, you can't, it's already built in, so you can't spam it. Yeah, it's already built that way. Yeah, how do I know? I'm 35 years old. I've been down a couple of these roads. I think we're ready to start this. Oh, actually, let's do no. I don't want there to be. Start with I equals 1. So it doesn't put one straight up. Yeah, there we go. Cool. All right, next thing we need to make this start looking better. Start to do the art. Yeah, so it totally works that way. Move the grass around the body. Oh, right, her body. Yeah. There, I will be able to do that. Yeah, it will actually naturally do that once I get this all set up right. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. Oh, nice. Huh. Oh. Right. Right. So I did start drawing this with a reference image of Hawk Girl. So here's kind of like my reference image of Hawk Girl that I was using. Right. So that's kind of the inspiration was Hawk Girl, sort of. And I made her kind of like pixely. So I'm going to leave her visible for now. And I've got a palette I've already created. I'm just going to start shading now. I can't sample her though. I gotta sample this palette over here. will any of us? Hey, dude, come to Burning Man. You'll probably see some. When's the burn? It just got over. Yeah. It just ended this last weekend. So it basically was all of last week. And it always ends on Labor Day for us Americans. Yeah, it totally just got over. It's the first year I haven't been in like 5 years. So it would have been my 6th year at Burning Man. But we chose to use all of our vacation time this year for going to Canada and all this stuff on a cool road trip. So next year, next year, next year. Right, yeah, exactly. Why do we flip everything over here in America, huh? Yeah, next year. Yeah, seriously, if any of you guys are going to Burning Man, please let me know so we can hook up. Meet you on the playa, show you around. If you haven't been yet, I'll show you some cool stuff for sure. It's definitely one of my favorite events of the whole year. Oh yeah, nice. Yep. Everything's bass ackwards. Yeah, definitely working on that. Totally cracks, breaks, for sure. Got this other image I can use as a reference too. It can help me do the shading. I'm definitely not an expert at doing art yet, so I definitely need help when it comes to. Oh, that image doesn't work for this. All right, I guess we're just gonna have to figure it out. Light's gonna hit the up here. Draw kind of like a collarbone here. Too much? Yeah, that's too much. Yeah. Yeah. We got nipples. This is definitely Peggle 18. Right. Dot dot dot. I almost need one more color. I think I'm gonna add another color to this palette. So between here and there. This one and that one, we need another color. Yeah, I definitely need to work on the arms. Is she nude? Pretty much. I'm thinking she's gonna be nude except for this helmet. The light's from above. Above and the front. So it's like a angle down from above, from yeah. Like sunlight. That's be almost behind the player just a little bit and coming from pretty much directly above. So this is a brightness of 39 and that's a brightness of 33. Saturation 13, saturation 19. Weird, but all right. Am I Walter White? Who's that? Welcome to the stream, Fire X. Oh, Toik. Oh, this is a really good question. Welcome to the stream, by the way. Yeah, this was 4 months of preparing. So yeah, I basically started off this project in November of 2014, and I thought, you know what? I'll throw together a game as fast as I can, hopefully within a week. And I'll throw it on Kickstarter to see if my game has merit and to see also if I can get the funds. So that was my original intention, and I realized that was just oof, that was a really horrible idea. So I spent basically 4 months developing a prototype that would enable me to create a good enough video. That was the thing. I could have created a Kickstarter campaign, but it wouldn't have had very good video. I wouldn't have been able to actually convince people that this is a cool enough game, you know? So even the way the Kickstarter was, I could even now the graphics are so much better than it was then. So it's like it's really a balance. It's like when do you do your Kickstarter? I think as early as you can, but really you do need to, I think at least, you know, depending on your project, you need a few months at least to prepare not only your graphics for your game, your prototype for your game, but also to prepare the following for your game. So I started doing all these live streams and I started posting on Twitter every day, and that built up a following too. So that 4 months of prep time was prepping the following and prepping the game to be able to be ready for a Kickstarter campaign. And I don't think it's very much of a hope for the best type thing. I at first thought it was. I was like, well, I could just hope for the best. But now that I look back on it, there really is a lot of marketing involved. And the marketing, you see me do it every day. This is really my marketing, is just this Twitch channel. And also my posts on Twitter and posts on other things like Tumblr and IndieDB and things like that. So, yeah, I hope that helps you there. And I'm also going to be doing a whole blog post about that. I've got it halfway written. I just got to finish this thing. So this is kind of like my blog post I've started. It's only halfway done though. So, but I am going to be posting a ki some kind of blog post about how to do your own Kickstarter. Yeah, Gladiator, totally, totally. How long can you run a Kickstarter campaign? I think you can run it technically as long as you want, but they recommend 30 to 45 days. What's up, Brunsbear? What? No more food? What happened? Cool, I hope so, Gladiar. Whoops. Oh yeah, I want to do one more color in this palette. Oh, weird. Try refresh, Marza. Hey Noah, what's up, man? I'm doing good, man. I'm working on this new level entrance. So halfway from 33 to 39 would be 36, about. Yeah, this will really help to have that extra color in there. Maybe a little more saturated. Up that saturation just a tiny bit. Kind of match this color. Yeah, that's kind of a nicer blend. Well, maybe a little less actually. Maybe more like that. One more. Little touches of art make such a big difference. Yeah, Gladiator, I've been planning on that. I'm gonna take all my time-lapse videos and then time-lapse those to make a giant time-lapse video once it's all done. I don't know, man. But, yes, Jonah 19, time lapseception. That's what it's gonna be. All right, cool. Now we got a better palette. Marza, what are you doing now? Brunsbear, it's gonna be underneath. So most of the time you've seen me do level entrances that are they go up in the air, but some of the levels in this game are actually gonna be underneath the ground. So they're gonna be like subterranean. So basically there's underneath her, there's gonna be a little like black. Let's just draw it right now. Like a little cave entrance, right? You walk down this cave entrance, and inside there's a cave that has an elevator that goes downward. What's up, fun? Oh, yeah, I know. Yeah, perfection is definitely one of those things where you've got to relax it a little bit to be able to do art. Especially pixel art, yeah. But it's learned for me as well, Gladiar. I had to learn this. I am definitely a perfectionist too, especially with things I create. Like, for example, I haven't even released a lot of the music I've written because I'm such a perfectionist. I'm like, oh, it's not so good, blah, blah, blah. But it's kind of a disservice to people that might be interested in that music. So one of these days I got to go and release some of that music. But you know what I mean? I had to get over it. I had to get over that stuff just to be able to even make this game at all. Too much Snickers. Yeah, I know. Yeah, pixel art is crazy like that, where you're like, man, just that one little pixel makes so much difference, or it's missing something. Yeah, pixel art can be that way. But vector art can be a little more friendly in that sense if you want to try it. What's up, Mighty Ness? Does it? Maybe I should make that a little less white then. Yeah, up there. Yeah, maybe I need one more color. Oh, and some of this is like, I don't really like any of that. Oh, thanks, man. Yeah, thanks, Mighty Nest. I appreciate that so much. Yeah, I'll be getting in touch with you shortly to ask you what name you want credited on the main menu. All right, let's do another highlight color. Right on, cool. Oh, dude. You gotta love Meatly. So good. Thanks, Jonah19. Thanks for sharing the most appropriate Meatlies ever, all the time. Another Chipotle? I like Chipotle. Both the restaurant Chipotle and Chipotle itself. That's 49, that's 70. No wonder it's such a big gap. Okay, let's do less. So 70, 49, that's about 20, so we want to do about 59. Maybe a little less. 55. Right, let's do this. Mega Man, of course. Mega Man's awesome. Yay! Welcome back, Marza. Don't ruin the stream again. Oh, that's not enough.59. What, is it gone again? That's a little better. This might be a little too shiny, but she's supposed to look kind of metallic. Oh, good, good. But yes. Beastie Warrior all day. Whoa! Cool. Yeah, there'll be some kind of lore or meaning, yeah. I'm not exactly sure what it is yet, but maybe if anybody wants to suggest a meaning, some kind of lore or meaning, feel free. There's gonna be a cave. Basically, underneath her, there is a cave. She's the goddess of music? Oh, I like that. What's up, Overcaster? I'm drawing this level entrance slash harpy slash hawk girl. Kind of rough right now, but working on it. That's interesting. Should Raven dump on her head? There you go. Yeah. Wow. Jonah19, this is so cool. This is definitely a suggestion I think could work well. Sort of has a nice, beautiful balance to it. Your idea here of she's the hero that people they want or deserves, but not the one they need. So crazy. All right, Overcaster man, thanks for saying hi. She's the keeper of the demons. Interesting. She could be the keeper of the demons. She could be one of the bosses. I like these ideas too. All right, I want to get an idea for if she's even like at the right brightness, contrast, and all that. So, putting her in the game. That's right. Oh, yeah. Oh, the one who imprisoned the demons, like Keeper of the Demons. Oh. Interesting. Yeah, Momir, this could work too, 'cause I've already got Vel, the other girl who's an actual character in this game. She was frozen in cryosleep. She's kind of meant to be the big hero of the previous war that like imprisoned all these demons, right? But maybe this girl was really instrumental in making that happen too. Oh, wings that make the robot fly faster? I like that. Ah, that's interesting. It's a nice twist. Oh yeah, no, she's actually from yeah, she's from like 10,000 years before this game even takes place. So, she's from a previous war. Oh, each dungeon boss will you kill will leave you a piece to unlocker? Interesting. Huh. All right, that's This might be too much light on her body. I'm wondering if I did anything in the area creation. Oh yeah, she does have a color. What? Cool, I like this too. I'm gonna write that down. Marza. Yeah, now see, I like that. That's what I was kind of what I was thinking. Somewhere in the dungeon, it would be a secret that you find. Okay, so there's her without any coloring. Let's play with these colors. Because this color is a little too dark. A little too saturated. Yeah. What's up, Blind Hack? Deshaun? I almost wish I had a softer color for that. Okay, well anyways, let's just keep going. For Marza, it's gone and then back, and then gone and back. Thanks for following. Oh, I like that. That's cool. Thanks, Sean. Cheers, man. I'll probably get to be playing the game at some point. Not that much, but. Yo, yeah, what's up, Lighter Thief? Definitely sexy lady time. How you doing today, Lighter Thief? Yeah, Rusty, what's up, man? Yeah, I know, right? Yeah, thanks for replying there on that on the thread there. It is cool. What game are you working on, man? Definitely, I think Cocos 2DX is actually an excellent engine for desktop games. It's just the history of it all came, it came from Cocos 2D, which was more mobile, so that's why most people are kind of using it for mobile. Oh, I don't know. It's all right, all right. Yeah, they just added it like Sunday, like just this last week. No, Friday even, last Friday. Something like that. They released 3.8 and then they had just announced it like yesterday or the day before. Oh, really? Ah. Thanks, man. Yeah, hopefully I can get it to look a little better. I'm really not quite happy with the shading yet, especially the highlights. The highlights look a little too highlighty, especially down here on their lower body. So maybe I'll go just with a little slightly less bright highlight down here. And then I gotta draw some kind of cool enclosure for a cave entrance below her. Oh, what? Oh, what did they add? Oh, sorry, man. What did they add? There's a they did do a they finally did a I think they did a blog post on it, or there's a forum post on it. There it is. There you go, Marza. Oh, Zoinks, I've taken a wrong turn. What were you trying to show me there, Brunsbear? I am signed in. Yeah, it's a 404 for me too. That's weird. Is it just not allowed or something? Yeah, I'm definitely signed in. Yeah, you're welcome, man. Yeah, it's I think it's mostly a mostly fixing bugs type of release. I think that's what they're intending it to be, is mostly bug fixes, but I think there's a few new features and stuff. Oh, nice. Right on. Thanks for submitting. Yeah, I think they I know I submitted a couple too. So, yeah, we all submit a few bug fixes here and there and helps them out because they do a lot. They do a lot of work to make that thing sing. Nice. Nice. Oh. Nice one. He's like a walking head. Cool. Hey, what's up, Booba Bart? Yeah, check it out. So you know how Cocos 2DX, you've Or at least I wrote that thing called Rapid Game, which pre-compiles Cocos 2DX. It's the same thing with their new Cocos command has a genlibs command. So you go Cocos genlibs, and it can like pre-compile all of Cocos 2DX, a lot like Rapid Game. So hopefully I won't have to keep big updating Rapid Game. That'd be sweet. Yubar, you're asking why I'm without music because I put my videos on YouTube every day, and YouTube flags my music or my videos if there's any music in them that's copyrighted. Nice. I think I might like this arm better than that arm. These highlights are just a little too highlighty. And this color, let's tone that down a little bit too. Yeah, that's better. Oh, so much better, man. No, you are. This is C++. That's right. That's all it is. Yeah, thanks, Marza. Yeah, oh, they finally wrote an article about it too. Oh, sweet. Yeah, so if anybody's just following along, if you're a Cocos 2DX user, I wrote this thing called Rapid Game, which I'm so kind of glad that they did something similar. Because I've always been pre-compiling Cocos 2DX using this tool called Rapid Game. But basically, if I'm going to try out this new genlibs command, and if this works, there's really no more need to ever keep updating Rapid Game because this was a bitch. This was a hell of a lot of work to do this. And so I'm really glad that I don't have to do this anymore if this all works out, if it works on all platforms and all that, which Could be hella awesome. That's gotta be it, Lighter Thief. That's gotta be it for sure. So yeah, a couple people have asked me if I will ever be in the game or anything. So maybe I'll do a wizard that's supposed to represent me. I like this Lighter Thief. This is how it's gonna be, the one Easter egg. She's definitely a Simpson, yeah. Yeah, this is multi-platform, you Bart. Yeah, I've definitely heard of Live GDX. The ninja? Are we talking about Nico? Nico the ninja? Okay, so if she wasn't. Yeah, so that just looks weird. Oh, right, yeah. Do I think Kokos is better? This totally depends on you, Bart. This is a good question. Is Kokos ODX better than Live GDX? It totally depends on what you prefer. If you prefer Java, Live GDX is going to be a better solution for you. If you prefer C++ or C++ based languages like that, that look like this, then you're going to prefer Kokos 2DX. They're both kind of similar in the fact that they're cross-platform and they're well-developed engines. So it really depends on what you prefer. I know, right, Brunsbear? It's crazy. A ninja quest to save energy. Energy with the N first. I really got to get this finished up so we can get the bottom part working. Yeah, that's also good. Thanks for putting that out there. Yeah, Mars Power. Yeah, Jessica, I'll show you the game so far. Here's the game so far. I can run it without building. We'll see. All right. So yeah, you're this character here, Rock. This is your main hero. Your friend, that robot there, his name is Jib. You start the game on this your spaceship called Songbringer, and you find this sword in a cave, and it It's a great sword, right? But it unlocks this ancient evil army from waking up. Or, I mean, it wakes up an ancient evil army. So, yeah, it's a lot like Zelda 1, but it's procedurally generated. So it generates its whole world based on 6 letters that you give it. So, yeah, this is what it looks like. This is kind of the game. There's a lot more to it. There's a big overworld, right? So there's... So there's a big overworld, just like Zelda 1 had a 16x8 overworld. This also has a 16x8 overworld, which is also procedurally generated. You have lots of items. Like here's a, you can throw your top hat. You can teleport forward a few steps. Oh, those guys work me. Yeah. There's also this rad item called the teleport cube, and you can use that once you've cleared the current area of enemies. You can warp back to your ship. You can also craft items. So there's item crafting. You basically can, if you find 2 items that can be crafted, you can take them back to your ship to this droid smith dude. And the droid smith will craft the items together. In fact, this fire teleport orb right here is the crafting of the teleport and fire. And then also this fire sword is a crafting of the ghost sword plus fire. So yeah, I'll use my teleporter cube and I'll go back to the ship and show you what that looks like a little bit. But there's overworld and there's 9 dungeons and there's lots of secrets, and once again it's all procedurally generated based on your 6 letters. So basically every time you play the game you can play a new adventure if you want by entering its different 6 letters, or you can enter the exact same 6 letters if you want to play a world you know and love. So there's an item combo that doesn't work. He doesn't like that. I don't really have any items right now that can be combined, but this is kind of what your ship's going to look like. There's going to be 4 other areas on the ship, and dungeons look a lot different too. So there, hope that's a nice intro to the game. Oh, really? No way, there's actually Nico the Ninja? Oh my god. Oh my god, I have to email my friend about this. This is so great. I actually have a friend, Nico, and we were doing a live stream one time, and he was on the live stream, and we were calling him Nico the Ninja, and I never knew there was actually a Nico the Ninja. Can I recommend a tutorial? Yes, I can. I can recommend one of the best tutorials about game development ever. Extra Credits. You've probably heard of Extra Credits or seen a few of their videos. They have a great series about making games. And here's the link. Yeah. Yeah, the $64 level gets to play the version that's coming out this month. It might be on Android. I don't know. It depends on if I can get the funds to continue developing it. Cool, man. Yeah, you have Bart, the Kickstarter is already over, but you can still support the project if you want. So yeah, there's a songbringer.com pre-order. If you want to pre-order the game, you also get your name in the credits. So this is how you can kind of become a backer of the game. And so yeah, basically anyone who backs or who pre-orders the game gets their name in the credits. And let me show you what that looks like. On the main menu, everybody's that's backed the game or even backed it after the Kickstarter through pre-ordering gets their name, whatever name you choose. So you can like email me and tell me what name you want to put on there. And this is what that looks like. So you're on the main menu and these are backers names right here. So Gary Turpentine Mahone. Thank you once again, backers. Heck, half the backers watch this stream. Bender. That's a cool one. Serious Creeper. Oh, he's not on right now, but Serious Creeper is a cool guy. He's making his own game right now. No, not really. It goes in spikes. Really, it goes in big spikes. Like when I was doing the Kickstarter, it was a huge spike. And yeah. So I got to work on it. I got to work on getting traffic to that. But I think what more importantly, this live stream is probably the best marketing ever. It's so great to do live streams because you get to truly interact with people instead of just like marketing to them or letting the website do the traffic or whatever at all. Doing the live stream, I get to actually interact with you guys, you know, it's just cool. And I also get to help you and like, you know, we build a relationship of cool stuff. You guys help me, I help you. You guys teach me cool stuff, I teach you cool stuff. So, yeah, I love doing the live stream. Okay, that's kind of a good enough body for now. Let's start to get to some kind of like enclosure below her. No, he's making a platformer game. What's up, Coin? Man, it's going great today. I'm working on this this sort of sexy harpy slash hawk chick that's gonna be a level entrance. So right beneath her feet there's some kind of cave entrance or something. Why is that? We're still good. Oh, yeah, it already does that. Did you see a repeat or something? What's up, Grim Gary? Agent Weiss? Agent Weiss? Is there an Agent Weiss? Who's Agent Weiss? Okay. Yeah, I'll check that then. Oh, I never saw that one. Gosh, why haven't I seen Reservoir Dogs? Yeah. But I'm not sure if I even updated the code since then, so it's a good thing to go and check that and make sure that is working. So I'm gonna open up this one sprite for, I think it's called Stairs or something. Stairs, no. Rock something, rock stairs. Oh, what is it? What is it? Rock. It's not an overworld, is it? Oh, there it is. I'm working on this drawing right here for this girl. She's like a, it's gonna be a level entrance. So she's yeah, I gotta work on her feet and everything, but yeah, this is kind of what she'll look like. I know, right? I gotta see it for sure, alert. What's up, Naceros? Yeah, here it is. Okay, so let's grab this sort of level entrancy thing. Actually, this kind of works. Yeah. Oh, that's nice. This will work. Something like this. Maybe a little taller, though. All right, let's see what that looks like with a combo of that thing and her. So I'll export her again, kind of how she is now. And then let's put some stairs right below her. Oh, I gotta put the player back at the right point, which was center. 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4. 9, 4. Well, we're only at 9, 5. Yep, it's not launching now, but the alpha is launching later this month. So the advanced alpha version or whatever. So alpha is coming out this month, 2 months more from now, so maybe November-ish. There's going to be the official beta versions coming out to all the backers and people who pre-order. And then last of all is the actual release, which will be probably January. Oh, that's. First of all, why did I do that? Evil Awakening, let's put that to 0 or 1. And she was below. That's weird. Why was she below? This thing Z is 1. It shouldn't be. It should be fine. Huh. That's weird how that Z ordering is turning out. Yeah, insert montage All right, so yeah, this definitely needs to look better, right? We got to get this thing looking right. I think she needs to be a little higher. Let's put her up at five. Oh yeah, she doesn't need that pillar. And this thing needs some rocks around it. Yeah? You mean her body or the entrance? Okay, all right, cool. Well, no worries, we'll get that. I'll get that fixed. Now it's on the list. Huh, maybe. What's up, Kotix? Okay, so you think your body needs more outline, yeah? Okay. Around these stairs, we need. Actually, let's do a loop here, 4xy. We love you too, Marza. Nice. Good job, man. There, that should give it sort of some tiles around her. Yeah, Kotix for sure. Let me get you the link to that. All the links for Songbringer and all my videos and everything are here on songbringer.com. And here's the YouTube one. I need to make these little links bigger. Yeah, every day's videos are there. Oh. No one. I'm just putting this out to the whole internet. No one call Marza tonight. There's no need to call Marza. Marza, don't even need to call him. More links. That's good. Oh, that's weird. Oh, I've got to change this one to four. Oh, and this should just be the stairs position dot x plus, and then stairs position dot y plus y. Much better. Yeah, it's yeah, I do. We have good internet here in the Bay Area. And we have like an upgraded package. So it does cost me like $80 a month or whatever for internet. But at least it's freaking awesome internet. Marzu? Rails, right on. Marzu. Ciao, Marzu, bello. Buongiorno. Ah, so weird. I wonder why she. Oops. That's so weird. Ah, look at that. Oh, it's so funny to see it broken like that. Well, okay, what's next? What's next? Oh, buonanotte. Why do I stream at 15 frames a second? Because somebody told me to do that a long time ago when I was starting out my streams. We were kind of trying to like dial this in so people were having a better experience. Like it looked better for them and it downloaded faster for them or something. It turned out. So I mean, I can always try playing with that and changing my frame rate to be 30 or whatever, but this somehow worked a lot better, but that was months ago. That was like March or whatever. So I can always try playing with that again. If you guys if anybody votes like, yo, put it up to 20 or 30 or whatever. Let me know and I can try that next time. But it might make your stream, it might make watching somebody, it might make watching the stream harder for some people. I don't know. I don't know how that works. Okay. Non ti permettere, my Pew. What am I saying? What am I even saying? Gracias. Una cerveza, por favor. All right, well, okay, so what should I work on, the code or the art? Let's at least get her so she doesn't have the pillar. She doesn't need this base anymore. Maybe that'll make her at the right. Oh, there it is. Oh, I see what's wrong. She's got a Z really high. That should be zero. Doesn't need to stand on this pillar thing. Oh, cool. What's up, Wissiso? Brad Pitt's Inglourious Basterds, yes. Buongiorno. That's so weird how that works. I like seeing this bug. This is a cool bug. Meow. What did I say? I'm so curious. Oh, don't you? Oh, you said what you just said now. I get it now. Arrivederci. Oh, we're talking about the frames per second of the stream. The stream's at 15 frames a second because that's kind of what people were telling me to do a while ago. So, what's up, Racer Nah? Welcome to the stream, man. Right on. Cool, man. What Dutch words are gonna be? Oh, I got it. She can be a really high Z, actually, like 1,000. And then the pattern, let's put her the hark paws at like 7, maybe. Nice, dude. So great. I didn't know there was such a cool little like pole thing, straw pole. It's rad. Okay, she's not on top yet. Why isn't she on top? She's supposed to be on top. Ragazzi, stato bello stare con voi tutta la sera. Oh, buonanotte, I know what that means. Exercise? Dude, I'm gonna exercise my Google Translate skills. Oh, nice. Good night, Mars of Power. All right, first I'll dial in the height of where she should be on the screen, or the Y. So like she can go up at least one more. Let's put her up one more tile. And the stairs entrance too, at least one more tile. Oh, maybe even one more. Yeah, you're definitely right, Lighter Thief. She does need to be darker on the edges to give her more depth. Yeah, good call. Yeah, I do want to do some nice shading on her wings and stuff. Okay, so why isn't she drawing on top of those stairs? It's so weird. These stairs are like So, huh. I mean, they are Z, right? Maybe this should be 2000. Oh, you wrote this thing? I it's so funny, right? Usually you write anything with Emacs or Vim. I think maybe the stairs are yeah. I think that this might work, putting her even higher, but yeah. Yeah, totally. She's yeah, whoops, sorry about that. Refresh the chat window again. Duh. I'm just gonna try and get her Z right and her height to be in the right position, then I'll keep drawing her even better. There, okay. Even though that's not gonna be perfect, right? Like she could be. I guess that's fine. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna keep drawing her now. She needs more of a base. All right, Bronze Bear, good night, man. Dude, what do I gotta do about this? Just refresh it? Oh, I don't know how to do this. No, sleep. Oh, noes. Oh, got results. All right, thanks, man. Duh. Oh, there's a big results button. Sorry, man. Oh, we gotta keep it at. Oh, what? 30. Oh, most people are voting to go to 30 next time. Well, I can't change my settings right now, but next time I'll do this. So. I know. I'll try it next time, and like during the first 15 minutes of the stream, we'll try it out. Yeah. So, yeah, next stream I'll start out trying it. And if it fails or whatever, I'll just restart the stream and put it back to 15. So, there's. We're using fastest filter. Video bitrate, this is important too. That's at 1800. I think that's about good, right? All right, Jonah, good night, man. Will it? It will for sure. So the maybe that's why people were saying. Maybe a lower res? Okay. Okay, so anyways, I'll play with these tomorrow. Like, whoops, that's not it. Here, settings. Yeah, okay, so I could try increasing this a little and then try. Maybe I'll try 20 frames a second or 25, and s something like that. Okay. Well, no, the output's at 1800 for the video bit rate. And then yeah, video resolution is 1280 by 800, which is the size of my screen. Yeah, like I just said there, it's 1280 by 800. Okay, so before I go, I'm actually about done with the stream here, but before I go, I want to try a little darker edge, especially on her legs. And doing something like this, like a little dais or something like that. Even though this will probably have to be a different color. Like lighter, but yeah. The base resolution is 25. It's exactly twice that. It's 2560 by 2560 by 1600. That's my retina resolution, basically going down to regular resolution. So this is what my resolution would be if it wasn't retina. So just a 2-to-1 type thing. Cool. Cool. All right. Cool. Thanks for all the thoughts, you guys. So I'll definitely keep it at 1280 by 800. I'll try 20 or 25, or maybe I'll just try 30. Oh, really? Okay. Huh. Well, I might try experimenting with it for the beginning of tomorrow's stream. All right, Enoch, see you, man. Yeah, it's specific for this screen here. Okay, so let's see what she looks like with legs like that. Yeah. Yeah, that definitely will look good if I apply that whole technique to her whole legs and rest of her body. Just to give her a little more contrast. Yeah, okay. Anyway, so that's what I'm going to work on tonight. That's basically it for today's stream. I gotta get some dinner and stuff. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, you guys. Thanks for entertaining me. I really appreciate you guys. It's fun to do streams and I hope they're awesome. Yeah. So yeah, cheers. I'll be back tomorrow, 2 p.m. usually is what I'm shooting for these days. See you guys. So yeah, I'll be back tomorrow, 2 p.m. Pacific time.